Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And exciting new video this, I think, at least for me. New plane from Hobby King. Jurafly Bonanza. Yay! It was announced a couple of months ago and I wanted one instantly. I think it's a nice looking airplane. No fuss. It is pretty basic actually. Not too big, so easy to transport. And yeah, it was released yesterday at the time I'm shooting this video here. I ordered one. Voila! So that's the second good thing about this airplane, I think. It's relatively cheap, inexpensive, especially for a Jurafly. And it was here in one day and the transport costs were zero. Yay, thank you very much. And I really don't know if that's true all over the world, but here in Europe, there were no transit costs for this model. Cool. So, the Bonanza, it is modeled after the Beechcraft Bonanza. You might be familiar with that airplane. It is a civilian style of airplane. That's nice, I like that. It's kind of scale, but the unusual, if you will, thing about the Bonanza, at least this version, is that it has a V-tail, and we'll have a look at that in detail in a minute, of course. There, in real life, there is a version of the Bonanza with a conventional tail, but I'm glad Hobby King went for the V-tail. It looks more unusual and I like that. So in this video, we'll have a look at what's in this box, and we'll also be building the plane. In a separate video, we'll be flying it, and maybe by the time you are watching this here video, I've already flown it, and there'll be a link somewhere up there to my flight video of this new Jurafly aeroplane. Now, one thing that confuses me a little bit is this branding. See, this is a smaller airplane, sub 1 meter airplane. It doesn't have landing gear, no flaps, no lights. So I would have branded this one, if I would have been Hobby King, an H King product. The Jurafly models generally have a landing gear, flaps and such. Yeah, the EFX Racer is close to this one, but that's more expensive, as you know. This is more of maybe an entry level kind of plane. But oh well, who cares? To fly this plane, you will, of course, need a transmitter, at least a 4-channel transmitter, a receiver, also 4-channel, of course, minimum of 4-channel. You will need a flight LiPo, a 1300 3S, approximately. And I haven't looked inside the box, but I assume it'll need an XT60 connector. Hobby King, please put that in the specifications on your product page. But again, I think XC60, but we'll see in a second. To assemble this plane, you will also need a screwdriver, and I think it'll be a Phillips head screwdriver. And you'll need some glue, and I'll be using Yuhupor. I'll have a link to that in the description as well, in case you you don't have that. And all control links have ball links on them. So if you have a ball link plier, that'll help you out. But I think you'll be able to assemble the plane without one. Anyway, it'll make things easier. Okay, let's have a look what's in this box. While I'm unpacking things, I'll put some specifications of this plane on screen for you. And obviously you can pause the video if you want a closer look at those specifications. And yes, I do not know what the actual specifications of the motor of this airplane are. They are not listed on the Hobby King site. in case I run into the specifications of those of the motor, I'll put them in the description of this video. Cool, we've got ourselves some parts. We've got two wings. Great, always nice to have two wings on an airplane. We've got two tail surfaces. We've got ourselves a fuselage. We've got two fuel tanks, wingtip mounted fuel tanks. And some small parts, a plastic skid plate, which will obviously go onto the bottom of our airplane. We've got some wing joiners from the looks of it, plastic wing joiners. We've got two push rods. Those will be for the tail surfaces. And as you can hopefully see, they have ball links on them, as mentioned before. We've got two screws, which will probably, pretty sure will join the wings to the fuselage. We've got an aluminium V-shaped wing joiner, a spar joiner, basically. And we've got a Y harness, which is for the ailerons. So this way your ailerons will only take up one channel. So there's no second Y harness, which means that you will need to set up the tail with two channels. On some planes you can opt to just run one channel for the tail. In that case your V-tail will only be two elevators and not rudders. I hope that makes sense. But this is a four-channel plane, full four-channel. Now let's have a detailed look at the parts. As mentioned, two wings. This is the bottom of the wing. And as you can see, the servo is already installed, as is a servo cover, plastic servo cover. The ball link is already attached, which is nice, and you've got some visual markings which will aid you in orientation while flying. Thank you very much. Durify decal, Bonanza decal, and there is a carbon fiber rod, or carbon spar in the aileron. Thank you very much. The ailerons are pretty wide but also pretty narrow, as you can hopefully tell. At the top, pretty plain. There's some decals already applied, so you have no decals to apply yourself on this airplane. And over here you've got the servo wire for that aileron. Cool stuff. Now, as mentioned before, you've got two fuel tanks, scale fuel tanks, and they aren't identical. As you can hopefully see, this is where the wing will slot in, and you'll have to glue those in. And oh, the fit is very nice. Whew. You won't need a lot of glue to keep those in. That's nice. Yeah, okay, that'll make life very easy. And yeah, obviously you get a second fuel tank. Yay, cool stuff. Okay, two tail surfaces, and these will form your horizontal and vertical stabilizers, obviously the big surface, and your elevators and rudder. And as you can tell, those also have a carbon spar in them to stiffen them up. The horizontal and vertical stabilizers themselves don't have reinforcement in them. How Yeah, there's a little bit of flex to them. This isn't a big plane though, so consequently not very heavy either. Would I have liked a spar in them? Yes. Speaking of, I haven't checked, but yeah, there's definitely, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that, but there's a spar running through, a square spar running through the wing over here. Again, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that, but I can clearly see it running through the wing up to here. Which is nice, and that aluminium joiner will slot in over here. I don't think there'll be glue required to hold that in, as you will be gluing the two wings together. Actually, maybe it would have been nice to have a one-piece wing. Might have been a little stiffer, but I guess that also would have made the plane a little more expensive. The molding would have been more expensive on a one-piece wing. The box would have been bigger, making the plane more expensive still. So I think this is a good choice. And again, it's not a heavy model. The wing loading won't be very big. So this will work out just fine, I think. And the last thing we found in our box is the fuselage, again with all the decals already applied. And I have to say that I like the color scheme quite a bit, which is part of the reason why I instantly wanted one when I saw it on one of the YouTube videos of HomeKing. So even the propeller and the spinner are already installed, as you can tell. Plastic spinner, and this looks to be an APC style of propeller. A 7x5 propeller, if I'm not mistaken, and a 20 amp ESC. Both brushes, obviously. Now, 20 amp ESC, do I think that's enough? Yeah, small model, not a very heavy model, so 20 amps should be more than enough. And we'll have a look if there is any air cooling. This is the canopy hatch, which will grant you access to the battery. Oh, I'm glad to see that there's some rubber padding over here, which will keep your battery in place. Thank you very much. Over here we have the ESC wire and battery. Ah yeah, an XT60. Thank you very much. So very nice and common style of battery connector. It also comes with this Velcro strap to strap your battery down. Cool. And here we have the two servo leads for the tail, and you'll stick the servo leads for the ailerons down through, or up, sorry, up through this hole over here in the fuselage at the bottom. That should be easy. Cool stuff. So air cooling. Ah yeah. Two air outlets, very nice. And obviously at the front we see two air intakes. Yeah, that should work out. And ESC, I can't see the ESC. It'll probably be somewhere underneath this battery plate, the black part. And yeah. Oh, I can't. No, I don't see the ESC, but look, from the looks of it, that ESC is in the air cooling path. What you also see is two metal tabs over here, so that canopy hatch thing is held in magnetically. Oh, there's a lot of room in this hatch, as you can see. So yeah, if you'd want to FPV this airplane, you can't really get to the rear section of the fuselage, as you can see here. But here, over here, you've got a lot of room for FPV stuff. So that's nice. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, so the servos on the fuselage are already installed, as you can see. One over here and one over here. And yes, I expect all servos on this airplane to be analog, so not digital, and plastic geared. And basically, I'm fine with that. And once they fail, you replace them with digital ones. If you'd replace the tail servos, you might have a slight CG issue. So in that case, you might want to add some nose weight. Okay, serviceability. I do see a little screw over here. It's behind the decal. And there's one over here as well. I was wondering about that, the serviceability, if you want to replace the motor, maybe upgrade the motor and ESC. But as you can see, well, if maybe you can't see, but there is actually a screw over here and over here. And if you take those out, I expect you'd be able to remove the front hatch, the motor nacelle or whatever it's called, and replace service your motor and ESC. So yeah, that's nice. I'd really like to know what kind of motor this is, but maybe that info will become available in the future. What you can hopefully also see is a little cavity over here where the servo leads come out of. You could tuck your receiver into there. Do be mindful about that though. You don't want to block this cavity because that's the airflow. So if you block this cavity over here, there will be no airflow through your fuselage for cooling of your LiPo and the ESC, and you don't want to do that. Right, so that's all the parts. Next thing we'll do is assemble this puppy. Here we go. Alright, I'm going to be starting with the two wings, gluing them together. Now there's no real order in which you have to assemble this plane. You could start with the tail surfaces. I've opted to start with the two wings. Okay, what you need is obviously the two wings. You need that skid plate, plastic piece. You need the two plastic wing joiner pieces. You need that aluminium spar joiner, and you need some glue. And again, I'm using U-Por for this. This is an excellent glue to glue foam models together. It's actually not so much a glue rather than a cement, and it'll fill all small little cavities in the foam, making the bond very strong. All right, here we go. All right, I decided to not have you sit through me applying glue and waiting for it to set. But needless to say, the two wings are now joined together, and I have to say that things feel quite stiff by now, so that looks good. I did add some tape at the top over here. I'm not sure if you'll be able to pick up the reflections of that. But that was just to keep things in place while the glue sets. Right. Okay, so yeah, that looks to be a done deal. Now the next thing you'll do is obviously glue on the two wing fuel tanks. And do be mindful that again they are not symmetrical, as you can hopefully see. So do a little test fit and you'll be good to go there. Next thing we'll do is attach the two tail surfaces. Alright, the two tail surfaces. Do I need to loosen up the hinges? Yeah, a little bit. So, that's what you first do, loosen up those hinges a little bit. Move them up and down, say, 5-6 times. Okay, and let's check if they stay in place while the glue sets. Does look like it. What I will do is run a piece of sellotape over them and remove that sellotape once the glue has set. That'll help you out. I was born with only two hands. Yeah, so but well, at least they stay in place while the glue sets. Now what I'll also do is add some glue in between the two tail surfaces where they join. And I'm not completely sure if that's necessary, but you need to, or you want all the mechanical advantage that you can get, right? Okay, so Yoo-hoo pour, and if you've never used Yoo-hoo pour, you don't use a liberal amount. You just apply a thin layer on all the surfaces, and then you put the thing you want to glue down in place, right? Then you remove it again. Yeah, so that's something you might not be familiar with other glues. You wait for approximately a minute or two. It depends a little on how warm it is in your house, but approximately 1 to 2 minutes. And then you set it down in place again. And again, I'll put a little bead of or strip of tape over this edge over here to keep things in place while the glue sets. And that's all there's to it. Okay, guess what? If you do exactly what I told you to do, so stick the pieces down, if you're using Yoo-hoo pour, take them off again, wait for approximately 2 minutes and then stick them down again, you don't need any tape. It kind of instantly slots into place, and it's well, it's been in approximately a minute now, and it's already very hard to move. So no, I won't be using any tape. This looks very nice. The fit of everything assists you pretty well in making sure everything lines up well. Happy with this result. Oh, by the way, obviously the ball links over here on the control surfaces go at the bottom of the elevators and rudders. Yeah, in case you were wondering, there's no real other way, but oh well. Just making sure. Next thing we'll do is attach the wings to the fuselage. This is the bottom of the fuselage, obviously, and you need the two screws. There are only two screws with this plane, so those are the screws you need. And you'll need a Phillips head screwdriver for this. Now, you could, in theory, opt to glue the wings down to the fuselage as well. You can then, well, I'm not sure if you'll be able to then still service the aileron servos. Yeah, those will probably be very hard to get to if you do that. So better not glue it down. There's no real reason for it either, I think. Okay, these two plastic tabs at the front of the wing will slot into the fuselage. You can't miss it. There are two holes over here at the front. And obviously, while doing so, you feed the two aileron servo leads into the fuselage over here into this cavity. Pretty simple. Hachiki day. Okay, and then you take your screws and screw them down over here. Okay, excellent. That went together very, very well. And by now, especially if I add the canopy. Damn it. This very much looks like an aeroplane. cool stuff and a very striking aeroplane, even though it's of moderate size. But yeah, looks cool, man. The fit and finish so far is great. Well, so far, this is basically all the assembly apart from two pushrods there is. So the two pushrods will obviously be for the tail surfaces. There's a Z-bend in them, which you will stick into the control horn on the servo, like so. And it looks like I've used the wrong one. But well, okay, that ball link is adjustable in length. And there's one for the other side as well. Again, applying that ball link onto that metal or brass ball is easier if you have a specific ball link plier, but well, you can probably do it by hand as well, otherwise a small plier and you're set to go. All right, the last thing on our agenda is setting up your radio and hooking up your receiver, obviously. Now, that'll be different on every other radio system. I'm using a FlySky system over here, but doesn't really matter. How I will connect up my receiver, I'll use channel 1. This one over here, the one with the Y lead in it, as my ailerons. That's that's my ailerons. And I'll use channel 1 for that one. Okay, and one of the elevators, or rudders, I'll use channel 2 for. Channel 3 will be my throttle, so the lead coming off of the ESC. Now, all servo leads in this model are clearly labeled. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that, but throttle 1. Rudder, elevator, I hope you can see that, but well, if you have this model, you'll definitely see that. So that makes life a lot easier. Okay, one thing you will have to figure out yourself is how to set up a V-tail in your radio. Now, I can't tell you how to do that because that's different on every radio system. But that is basically it. You'll have to check the CG, of course, with the battery installed. The CG should be approximately 7 centimeters from the leading edge, and that'll probably be approximately at the spar or at this, where the servo lead runs through the wing. But yeah, is that actually true? Nah, slightly in front of that. So slightly in front of this decal. That is basically it. Nothing more to it than to test fly this. Now I'm actually recording this here video at night, so I won't be flying it right now. The model doesn't have lights, right? So yes, I hope to be able to have a flight video of this nice looking Durafly Bonanza up in, well, in the coming days. And again, if you are watching this here video at a later date, it might already be up. Check my channel for flight videos of this Durafly Bonanza. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. I'll be happy to answer you and catch you on the next video. Bye bye.